Volcanoes are one of the most incredible phenomenons that nature has to offer, but you don't want to get too close to one. Why? Because, well, you'll see. Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions. I'm Rebecca Felgate, and today I'm asking, what would happen if you fell into a volcano? I guess you guys are a sucker for punishment. You loved our What If You Fell Into a Black Hole video, so maybe you just like learning about extreme epic scenarios that may or may not lead to death. But you know what? If that involves a little scientific explanation, we're very happy to feed your curiosity. Before we jump into this video, I just want to remind all of you guys to please hit that thumbs up button if you like our content. It just makes us feel good. Volcanoes are formed when magma from the Earth's mantle pushes its way to the crust and through to the Earth's surface. When it breaks free, it erupts to create lava flow and ash that build up over time, forming mountainous peaks. The more a volcano erupts, the bigger it gets. Nowadays, we're more able than ever to control how much damage a volcano eruption would do, with the biggest issue being the ash cloud. Of course, back through history, volcanoes have really done some serious damage. Mount Vesuvius, for example, devastated an ancient civilization in the Roman city of Pompeii. So, when we ask what would happen if you fell into a volcano, most of you will think that I'm talking about an active, lavery one, the kind of Bond villain would fall into and meet their poetic demise. Of course, you may now realize that not all volcanoes are active, and if you did fall into a non-active volcano, depending on the distance fallen and the crater accessibility, you might do yourself some damage, but you won't be smothered in fiery goo and screaming no as you sink into a hot hell, never to be found again. I guess that's the way they make it seem in the movies, but what if you fell into an active volcano in real life? Well, it might actually not look anything like you've seen in a film. Okay, so let's start with a common misconception about lava. Lava isn't really a liquid, it's a dense molten rock. It's 3 times denser than water, which means it flows, sure, but it doesn't trickle. I'm not sure if you've ever seen videos of lava flow, but it is possible with the right heat-proof pair of shoes to walk on it, and this would leave dents in the substance as you step forward. Now, my point being, unless you fell from a great height and hit the lava with a great force, it is unlikely that you would sink into the gooey substance if you fell into a volcano. The most likely scenario would be that you would land on the soft molten rock, which can reach temperatures of 1,200 degrees Celsius. If you were lucky, the fallen force would break your neck, so you wouldn't have to worry about the burning part. The burning part would not be nice. As the molten rock is so hot, it would cause your skin to burst into flames. For a body to fully reduce to ash, the heat of the volcano would need to be between 1100 to 1500 degrees centigrade, so it might not be hot enough to fully incinerate you. If it was on the cooler side, your bones would likely remain on top of the molten hot lava, charred and flaming. Great! If you did fall hard enough into the volcano to penetrate the thick surface, you would die instantaneously from the shock of the heat. Your skin would melt off immediately and, well, we'll save you the gory details, but you die and your body would be encased in lava. If you did hit hard enough to penetrate the surface of the lava, you could cause a violent outburst within, with spewing liquid lava creating quite the scene. If I had to fall into a volcano, this would be my preferred way to go. You gotta go out with fireworks, am I right? The most crucial thing standing in your way when it comes to falling in a volcano is actually getting close enough to the mouth of one. Things start getting very hot near a volcanic mouth, with temperatures exceeding 500 degrees Celsius near the rim. On top of that, there would be a lot of sulfur, methane, ammonia, and carbon monoxide in the air, making it likely that you would choke before you even got a chance to stare down into the fiery pit. If you were to get close enough to fall in, you would need specialist equipment to even get close, or I guess like a precision drop via an aircraft is a very distant and extremely unlikely possibility. My advice, volcanoes are cool and everything, but try not to get too close to their inner bellies. Save that kind of madness for Gollum and pals. So that was one question answered for you. What would you like us to answer next? Do let me know in the comments section down below. Also, please do once again remember to keep on hitting that thumbs up button and sharing our videos around the net. I'm Rebecca Felgate, your most amazing host. I'll catch you in the next video, but for now, stay curious, stay alert, and never ever stop questioning. If you want to continue your questioning binge, why not check out our biggest science questions and our biggest what ifs?